What's up, y'all? It's Phil, and it's time for our personal project. So I make a lot of doors and drawers, a lot of cabinets, a lot of custom built-ins, and a lot of cabinet doors, so I've got to have a place to paint all of these things. Unfortunately, I don't. So when I used to do a lot of dining tables, I used to run into this issue where I just wouldn't have room in my shop. I wouldn't have a lot of room out here to be doing work, and I definitely wouldn't have a lot of room in there to be doing the finishing. So I tried to kind of like stagger step them, work on one, finish another, deliver another, and like keep moving forward like that. That didn't really work out this time when it comes to the cabinets. One thing I've always wanted to invest in or to make myself is a cabinet drying rack. So I decided that today I am at my wit's end, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna show you how I do it. Unlike most of my DIYs, this is not gonna be an instructional video, but hopefully through watching it and seeing what I do, and I am gonna explain what I do as I go, you can actually go ahead and copy this yourself, or you can come up with your own ideas, kind of similar to what I did. I'm basing this off of a lot of what else I've seen on YouTube, but I'm building it for my space specifically and using the materials that I happen to have on hand. So let's get started. So now I've moved on to my finish room. I apologize for the sound because it's a little echoey in here, and I've got my air conditioner that I bought from Craigslist, and if I turn it off, it will not turn back on. So, sorry about that as far as the sound quality goes. A little while ago, I put up these racks, and when I installed these, I kind of left this space open. I typically buy either 8, 10, or 12 foot lumber. Most of the time I buy 12. It's the easiest thing for me to use, it gives me the most material, and it's one of the cheapest stocks that I can buy from my supplier. So I've got these two racks that are 12 foot long, and this rack down here that is 8 foot long. I don't do anything with any sort of big box store lumber except for some of my DIYs for hobbyists and DIY guys, but I usually buy that per project. I never have that on hand like I do for most of this. So there's one twisty piece of 2x8 there, and there's a not so twisty piece of 2x6 under here that I use as my current paint racks, but you're never going to see a stack of 2x4s in my shop. Sorry. But with that being said, I have measured this space right here. This is a completely useless space. It is full of junk, and it needs to be used for something, so I decided this would be the perfect spot to put my painting rack. So I measured the space just to make sure that it would work, and the easy way to measure that was by literally using a piece of scrap that I had left over and some of the doors that I'm currently painting, because these are the most common sizes that I'm making. So anything close to this size is going to be pretty average for me. As it turns out, I can actually get a ton of doors on here. I'm not sure of the total number, but it's probably going to be like 36 to 42 or something like that. I mean, it's going to be a lot of doors, so I'm excited about that. I don't have any casters here in the shop, but I may have a solution for that, and if not, I'll just go pick some up. So to get started, I'm going to actually use this piece of scrap. I was going to use this for a reference, and it turns out that it's pretty much exactly the size that I want this rack to be. So I'm going to use this as a reference for cutting all of my cross pieces that are going to hold the doors up. And I'm going to use some of this 13/16 poplar that I have, and that is going to be what I actually build the rack from and cut my other slats, because this is only one and I'm going to need like a bunch. So yeah, let's get going. This thing turned out awesome, and I'm super excited about it. I can actually get 26 doors minimum on this thing. There's 13 to each side, and if I double some of them up, then I don't really have to worry about it. I can get more on there. They're 25 inches wide, so they should only hold about one door each, but a lot of times I do some smaller doors that are only 12 inch or 17 inch, so I might be able to double up some, but again, I don't think I'm ever gonna run out of space on this rack because most of my projects don't involve this many doors. This is two projects worth of doors, and I've got more doors out there. They're all happening at the same time. Normally, I only have like 8, 10, maybe 12, so I think it's great. This rack is going to come in handy and adds a certain level of professionalism to my shop that I'm always striving to have. So this will be great. It's going to keep the doors up, keep them safe, keep them dust-free. I can put some fans on them, and when I'm not using it, I can put it away. When I am using it, I can pull it out to the middle of the room like it is here, and it'll be awesome. I know that some of you may not have the tools that I used in this video, and that's okay. Again, this wasn't an instructional video, it was just kind of an example of something I did for my shop. So feel free to make your own plans and try to figure out a way to do it. If you want to do this exact one, shoot me an email and I'll be happy to send you at least a cut list, and you can kind of build it from there. But something like this is simple and easy. You just have to use your imagination and do what you can do with the tools you have on hand and the skill that you have. If you want to get any of those tools, feel free to visit my Amazon store. Click on the links below and you can check out some of the things that I use, some of the things I've got in my shop, as well as some of my best recommendations for some of the products that I would either like to have or do use currently. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram, sometimes Twitter. Everything is at PMK Woodworking, so find me on there. If you do one of these projects, or if you make your own rack like this, or if you even got a better idea than what I came up with, send it to me. I want to see it. So hit me up on Instagram, slide into those DMs, and just let me know what you've been working on, what you've been doing, and I'll be more than happy to feature you on my page. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. And definitely feel free to share this all over the place, because I know there's a lot of people that would love to learn how to do something like this, and just seeing a couple examples can really get the juices flowing. With all that being said, I got some doors to paint, so we'll catch y'all next time.
See ya!